That's where he made his big mistake. When he chose to live too close to Saul. It was a poor moral decision. It was a poor moral decision. It was based solely on how it's the decision when we live a place. Is it based solely on how much of a house we can afford? Is it based upon a location to work, school, etc.? Do we consider whether it will help or hinder our service to God and His church? You know, like Lot is just close to Sodom. Today, the same way we can pitch our tent. We have Sodom and Gomorrah right here.
Amen.
In Baltimore City.
Amen.
See, we don't have to go back and say, okay, well, I don't know no cities like Sodom and Gomorrah.
Oh,
yes,
right.
You do. Yes, every city. It used to just be San Francisco and New York.
Yeah.
20, 30 years, you say, okay, it must be New York and San Francisco. Now it's every city.
Yeah, amen.
Has Sodom and Gomorrah. Every city has. Look, did we have a same-sex marriage law? Every city is Sodom and Gomorrah. Every city has men dressing like women and women dressing like men. Every city has drugs in it. And even the country, they did a program on National Geographic. And it was saying how people think that the drug and the methamphetamine used and the crystal meth and all that is used more in the city, but they said even in the rural, it's in the rural country, in the rural United States, where that the sales, you have more ads of more methamphetamine. Sometimes we think it's just us, and I got news for you. It's more rampant in your rural earth.
Okay, now.
It is. So every town has a Sodom and Gomorrah. In Matthew, the 7th chapter, Jesus tells us to build our house. He tells us in making a decision of where to live, He tells us where the decision we need to make. Matthew 7 and 24, He talks about two foundations. He says, therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and acts on them may be compared to a wise man who built his house on rock. And when the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and slammed against that house, and yet it did not fall, for it had been founded on rock. Everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. The rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and slammed against that house, and it fell. And great was the fall. When we choose where to live, we need to build our house on a solid foundation. As a Christian, you need to build the house on Jesus, on your faith. See, the floods are going to come on every house.
Yeah.
The winds are going to blow. Elkin, where you live at? You may say, oh, I live in California. Well, guess what happens in California? Mudslides.
Yeah.
It's nice in California. Boy, it's sunny, and people just walk around. But guess what? The earthquake.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? You think that geographically you can choose where you can live, but sin is everywhere.
Yeah.
Sin is everywhere. You think that you can live, but you should be a time to live out in Columbia when they first built Columbia.
Yeah.
I'm living in Columbia.
Yeah.
Please. Yeah. It's sin everywhere.
Uh-huh.
It's in everywhere. So you gotta make your career, your choosing, choose where you live according to the faith that you have.
Amen.
In Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For every action, there is a reaction.
Yes, it is.
And for every choice, there is a consequence.
Yeah.
In Galatians, Paul wrote, don't you be fooled. You will reap what you sow. And when we make these decisions, the younger people, the young ladies and young men that are in this congregation right now, start making these career decisions now. But don't say I got a few more years and I can just live where I want, I can live how I want to. No, because tomorrow's not promised.
That's right.
And don't say I messed up already. I hear some, I done messed up so bad. No, but you got another chance today.
Amen.
to make the right career, the right decision on where you're going to live.
Yeah.
Some suggestions for making wise choices. In making wise choices, ask for wisdom.
Amen.
Ask God for wisdom.
Yes, sir.
You hear people, especially younger people, say, I know. You're trying to tell them something, I know.
Yeah, come on now.
I know. I'm stepping on some toes in water. They know what I'm talking about. You trying to say, okay, I know.
Yeah.
Ain't heard a word you said, and you got to get nothing out.
I know.
First, ask God for wisdom.
Uh-huh.
What can you do? If you want to make wise choices, ask God. He has all wisdom.
Amen.
He doesn't hold it back. James 1. 5-8. Asking for wisdom requires diligence.
Come on,
bro. Asking for wisdom requires you to be diligent. Then you ask one time, they say, okay, he didn't answer. You get up and say, oh, he didn't answer. Sometimes God has to take you through something to get to something.
Yes, sir.
You know, we want Jesus came and he suffered and he learned obedience.
Amen.
According to the Hebrew writing, he suffered and he learned obedience. So Jesus suffered and learned obedience. Why do we think it's disciples of Jesus? We're not going to suffer. See, because the suffering is what's going to purge and purify us.
Amen. Amen.
To make us meet for the master sheep.
Amen.
We need to ask others for advice.
Amen.
We need to ask others for advice. We need to go to those who are spiritual.
Come on, bro.
Don't go to somebody that's going to say, come on, let's party and have a drink.
Yeah.
Get over your problem.
Yeah.
And you know your problem is partying and drinking.
Yeah.
Then that's not the person you ask. But ask somebody. There is safety in having many counselors.
Yes.
According to the book of Proverbs 11:14. There is wisdom in heeding counsel of others. It's wise to go and talk to somebody that is older, more mature, that has experienced something. One thing that gets me when talking to, especially people that are younger and people that are older, but it's more prevalent among young people, is that when you talk to them, they'll tell you that they went to somebody their age, and somebody their age told them how to get through the problem. Or they go to somebody married goes to somebody single to try to get advice.
Yeah.
What?
Huh?
You are two different categories. Yeah. The single sister can't really tell you nothing about marriage.
Yeah. Amen.
Come on. But guess what? The sister that's been married for 40 years can tell you something. I'm married. Come on, tell you something. If you're honest with people, you talk to anybody that's married for a long time, they will tell you about some stuff.
Yes, sir.
That's really honest with them about, they will tell you. No. Yeah.
There you go.
That happens.
Right. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Come on.
God can get you through that.
Yes, sir.
Amen. It's those relationships you should be concerned about. When you see somebody that stays together, those are the ones you want to talk to.
Amen.
You walk out the house smiling.
Amen.
Asking for wisdom requires diligence. Fill your prayers with requests for wisdom to make wise choices. Ask others for advice. Ask others for advice. Commit your choices to the Lord. Commit your choices to God. To God. Tell God. See, one thing about it. I don't know too many people that will intentionally lie to God.
Amen.
They will intentionally say, I'm going to lie to God.
Yeah, right.
I'm going to pray, but I'm really lying. That God is who can give you wisdom. Trusting that you have made choices pleasing to Him, put them in His hand. When you make a choice, put the choice in His hand. Psalms 37:5-6. Make your choices with understanding, if the Lord will. See, don't say what you're going to do today and tomorrow. This is James 4:13-15. Don't say what you're going to do tomorrow. I'm going to get up. We're going to take a trip. We're Because, see, I've seen death. The closer I get to, I'm approaching 60. And the closer I get,
come on now.
Every year I'm seeing now the people I thought that you think in your mind is going to be there.
Come on.
They leave. And they leave it young and they leave it old.
Yeah.
They leave it young. Ain't no age specific.
Yeah.
I hear the news all the time. The life expectancy is now it's longer than it used to be.
Yeah, right.
People are eating different. Come on. Satan ain't playing. And God holds time in his hand. He holds our life in his hand. But we need to stop saying that making plans for the future that don't involve if it be God's will. That's what James said. Make your choices with the understanding if the Lord's will,
amen.
I will make it here. I'll do this. I'll do that. One might even ask the Lord if a choice is not according to his will, he might frustrate the crying out of his choice. You know that? We might even learn to ask God, if I made a choice and Lord, you know it's not according to your will, then he might frustrate the crying out, then he might make it hard for the choice to go through. That's why it's important to give to God. He might say, okay, that's not according to my will. And the more you try to make that choice but not according to his will, the harder it is for you to do it.
Amen.
That's your itch.
Come on, please.
That's your itch. Or to otherwise show that what is his will. Or to otherwise show you what is his will. Include God in your decision making if you wish to make wise choices.
Amen.
There will be times when it becomes apparent to us that we made poor choices. Amen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Might be 10 years down the road.
Yes,
sir. Might be tomorrow. But it comes a time when it's apparent you make poor choices.
Yes,
even the wrong ones.
Yes,
what can we do to avoid making matters worse? Respond to the wrong choice. Say I was wrong.
Yeah, amen.
First of all, don't walk around saying I'm right. You know you're wrong.
Amen.
Ain't nothing gonna change because your mentality, your attitude is wrong. You can't say to nobody you're wrong. And I know a lot of people in my workplace, everywhere,
yeah.
In the church,
yeah.
They can't say I'm wrong.
Amen.
They're like Fonzie. Remember Fonzie on Happy Days?
Yeah.
He could not say it, and he loved you, and he couldn't say I was wrong. You say, if you say, Fonzie, do you love me? He say, I love. And if you say, are you wrong, Fonzie? I'm wrong. He would never get it all out, and that's the way we are. But first thing, when you realize you made a wrong choice, is to say, I'm wrong.
Yeah.
I'm wrong. Heed the word of God.